Stroke, or just people in general, like to expand in a more not obvious area where that's not usually scouted as much. And that's an important thing with Starcraft. Scout as much as possible. I mean, it's really cheap to scout with like one marine, so. And I'm just checking in, scanning here, and seeing if I can get in, but I see his units blocking off the ramp, so I just back off. I lose one Hellion, so not too bad in that regard. And he has his Nexus up now, so he should be transferring probes pretty soon. And I just got my Banshees and Hellions AFK on the bottom right on the map, and I do have a second command center going down, so I'm going to be expanding pretty soon. Since I saw him expand, so I might as well expand too, so there's no point to lag behind. That's how a lot of people lose in StarCraft, is when the other person just out-expands you and out-macros you, because macro is heavily important in the game, whereas micro is still important, but a lot of the units now have like auto-microing, so they'll like, particularly like siege tanks, they won't. In StarCraft 1, you could send like one zealot in, and all the siege tanks would like barrage that one zealot, and then pretty much use that turn of shot on that one zealot. But in StarCraft 2, they'll only shoot enough siege tank shots to actually kill the zealots. So if there's like 10 siege tanks, only like 3 of them will shoot, and then the other 7 will kind of stay idle until there's, you know, pretty much you can't abuse that anymore. And we got a couple pylons going up to secure his natural with just pylon power grids. And I just expanded now, and my SCVs are going to bring their minerals back to the other base, but they should be mining out no time. I just kind of missed that, I guess. That's kind of a mistake on my part. I mean, that alone is literally like 150, 200 minerals, so you don't want to really do that too much. Now, maybe not 150, but maybe like 100. Just going for some scans, seeing what he's got, trying to scan out his army for one. And sending out my Banshee now to try and just snipe some probes here with cloak. A preemptive cloak, that is, because, yeah, just so he has less time to respond to it. And getting about 3 kills now. And maybe another stalker? Maybe another stalker? Maybe another stalker? Nope, doesn't look like I'm gonna get that stalker. Although I probably could. Not sure where Vonstroke's observers are right now. He definitely needs to either pump one or build a cannon or just bring his other ones back. And as you can see, he's not mining at all pretty much right now. And I'm sending my Hellions in the other side because I saw his transferring a probe, so I'm trying to get some Hellions probe kills here. I got a shit ton of probe kills right there. Right there. Like, I think I'm pretty sure I got like 10 probe kills in that one Hellion like blast. Maybe not 10, but you know, enough to satisfy my needs. And just using this Banshee to snipe out more probes, just getting pretty much free reign at this point. So very effective harass with this Banshee and those Hellions. No point to complain. I do see that fleet beacon, a couple stargates as well. I didn't actually think he was gonna go carriers, because if he does go carriers, it's pretty much game over. There's no way he can macro up to carriers at this point without me just like, you know, scanning him and finding those carriers. That's the problem with carriers in StarCraft 2. It's so much harder to actually do in some ways. I mean, carriers just seem a lot weaker for some reason in StarCraft 2. I'm not entirely sure why. Maybe it's just that there's a lot of like strong anti-air now. That they're not that effective. I mean, yeah. Battlecruisers are still kind of effective. Yamato Cannon, or Yamato Cannon. Yamato. Tomato, tomato. It's still pretty effective. And Battlecruisers are pretty strong still overall. But, yeah, I got some more Hellions that are about to come in and sneak on by the back of the mineral line to try and get some kills here. And looks like they're going for some blasts. I do not have an igniter upgrade at this point, but oh, about 6, maybe the 10, maybe like 9, something like that go down. That's another good harass. I've been beginning to really like the Hellion harass now. Because I really should get the Igniter upgrade though, because that will make it do a lot more damage. As you can see on the screen, my income per minute is extremely high compared to Vonstroke's, as I've pretty much been harassing him like the last 3 minutes of the game, and yeah, that's pretty devastating to his army. And now I'm going for my third expansion while he only has one mining right now. Although I pretty much only have one mining as well. I'm just saturating my third expansion at this point. Sorry, gotta yawn! Oh, sorry. It's quite a hot day today in Vancouver, BC. Pretty much I live in an apartment where the next apartment right next door is a white building, and the sun shines directly on that building and pretty much reflects into my room. So it's like a heater inside my room, which is pretty annoying. And we got a decent sized army for Vonstroke moving out now with a couple Phoenix and a mixed unit of Immortals and such. No Colossus, no Dark Templars, no High Templars in particular. And not sure if he has charge. Looks like we got a little bit of a back black screen here, but I'll be fixing that. Can't really commentate on what's happening. Oh, looks like that black screen just ended. Not sure why those happen. But glad it didn't last too long. And looks like he's trying to engage my forces at my third expansion. Little bit of micro, killing his Velos really quick, and then microing back my units with the Marauders and the Siege Tanks, pretty much nuking them out. And that's pretty much a slaughter fest, because that's not even my whole army, and I still have a couple Vikings, two Siege Tanks, and a couple Marauders left as well. Yeah. No, four Siege Tanks, rather. And I still have all my defenses at my base, because I never really transferred any. And just got a couple sensor towers up, and that's pretty much good game, so I'm going to be posting a couple more pretty soon, and stay tuned. So see you guys later, and have a good night. Bye. Bye.